of internal determinations here at the State Department.
I would say you've come out much more quickly than that. Given the amount of time that the bombing has been going on in Gaza, you've had enough time. You've had more time than in some cases.
We have not seen Russians warning civilians to vacate apartment buildings when they launch them. We've seen evidence in Russia's case of deliberately targeting civilian infrastructure.
So you have made some kind of assessment.
I'm saying that's the difference in the situation and facts that we haven't seen here.
But the fact that you have made a determination, because what you just said to Simon is that you made a determination that Russia deliberately targeted civilian, and you have made a determination in this case that Israel is not deliberately doing that.
I'm sorry, there's no other way to read what you...
Se io sapessi perché sono qui, non sarei qui.
We were able to show and make the determination in the case of Russia that they were intentionally targeting civilian infrastructure. We have not come to that conclusion here.
With Israel. Okay, so that means that you have thus far determined that Israel is complying with the laws of war.
It does not mean that. It means that we have not conducted. Again, Matt, I know you want me to make a claim that usually is at the end of a formal legal process, and I'm not able to do that.
I don't think that's correct at all. And in fact, it's exactly as Simon said. You guys are very quick off the bat to accuse Russia of, you know, and probably correctly, of committing war crimes and doing that kind of thing.
So,
but in this case. And it's now two and a half weeks in. You guys are saying, you guys won't say whether you will make a determination, even though many others have. Or many others have weighed in, either on the yes, they are complying, or no, they are not complying.
So
I think that what the world is looking for is a clear statement from you guys whether you think that they are heeding your advice, and it sounds to me as though you're saying yes, they are, but when you're pressed on that, you won't give an answer.
We believe they are listening to our advice, but I cannot make the formal make the formal determination when it comes to every one of the strikes that's been launched. Go ahead, Syed, and then we'll just very quickly.
So you're saying,
I do want to give other people a chance, but go ahead.
You're saying that dropping leaflets on people...
I'm sorry.
Dropping leaflets on people, telling them that we're going to bomb this site like 3 or 5 minutes before is actually complying with the laws of war. Is that what you said?
Saeed, I am not able to sit here at this podium and talk about the specifics of let me finish the answer.
Sure.
Of every individual strike. To make a determination of a war crime, you need to be able to do these very fact-specific determinations and compare them about what international law requires and see if the international law has been violated. I'm not able to make that assessment, certainly not as you know, with facts that you were giving to me about whatever strike.
You just said they informed them.
It's hard to look at what he's doing in Ukraine, what his forces are doing in Ukraine, and think that any ethical, moral individual could justify that. It's difficult to look at the... It's difficult to look at some of the images and imagine that any well-thinking, serious, mature leader would do that. So I can't talk to his psychology, but I think we can all speak to his depravity.
This is war. It is combat. It is bloody. It is ugly. And it's going to be messy. And innocent civilians are going to be hurt going forward. I wish I could tell you something different. I wish that wasn't going to happen, but it is going to happen.